Right now, we have our GMA cover story in a network TV exclusive interview with the first person implanted with Elon Musk's Neuralink. Will Reeve had a chance to sit down with him. Good morning, Will.
Good morning, Michael. Neuralink makes a device that gets surgically implanted in a person's brain, and the user can then control a computer or a smartphone using only their mind. And it doesn't affect physical movement for a person with a spinal cord injury, but for this first human participant, it's affected his life in profound ways.
I didn't have anything to wake up for in the morning. And this has changed that for me.
In a GMA broadcast exclusive, Noland Arbaugh, the first human implanted with a Neuralink chip in his brain, is telling his story.
I accepted that I was paralyzed and that was my life. I always held out hope that it would all get better.
At 22 years old, Noland says he dove headfirst in waist-deep water, struck something, and sustained a spinal cord injury. He couldn't move from the shoulders down.
From the time of your injury until earlier this year, what was your daily life like?
I mean, one thing about being paralyzed is that there's a lot of time to sit and think. And so I thought through basically my whole life and realized all the mistakes I'd made and what I could do better.
Then, just last year, Noland, now 30, receiving a life-changing opportunity.
One day, one of my buddies from college called me up. We talked pretty regularly, and he was like, hey, Neuralink, they opened up the human trials. And I said, what's Neuralink?
Neuralink, co-founded by Elon Musk, is an experimental implantable brain-computer interface, or BCI, a chip surgically implanted by a robot and connected by threads to a patient's brain that allows the patient to control a computer or smartphone with their mind.
This is all from there to there.
Yeah, man.
Wow.
Neuralink is not the only company working on this technology. Several others are also testing their BCIs in paralyzed volunteers. Noland now joins that small group as Neuralink's first patient.
I was just very happy that I would be a part of something that I believe is so monumental in this next step forward of helping people with paralysis.
What can you do now with the chip implanted that you could not do prior?
I can control a computer just like anyone else can, which is not something I was able to do beforehand.
You just played some music?
Yeah, man.
That's awesome. Do you worry, because you are the first patient, that something unforeseen could go wrong now that this is inside your head?
I wouldn't say worry. It was something where I knew that if I did this, then it would take a lot of headache and heartache away from the people down the road.
Just last week, news that some of the threads in Nolan's brain had retracted, affecting the performance of the device.
How'd you take the news when they told you that the threads had retracted?
Yeah, it was really hard. It was very, very hard to give up all of the amazing things that I was able to do. I think I had cried basically afterwards.
The problem becoming an opportunity for the makers of Neuralink to explore solutions.
The reason we do clinical trial and early feasibility trial is to uncover these sort of issues as early as possible before they get marketed. And we rolled up our sleeves and found various different ways to for Nolan be able to recover his performance, which we have successfully been able to do.
As for Noland, the future of the technology only looks bright.
It's going to be amazing when someone can have a spinal cord injury, go into a hospital, get surgery, and walk out a couple days later. I think it's going to happen. I don't think it's as far away as people might think.
Noland's mom is his primary caregiver. She cleans him and feeds him and gets him out of bed. And while this Neuralink device won't change any of Noland's physical realities, and it's still going to be hard for his family to live with his spinal cord injury, he says it's changed their life for the better. As for what's next for Neuralink, co-founder DJ Suh told me that they are looking to implant participants number 2 and 3 in the coming months, guys.
Yeah, it just seems incredible, Will. I'm glad he shared that story, and thank you for bringing it to us.